What's up, everybody? Today I'm actually at home recording, which is probably where you are or where you plan to be if you're looking to live stream your Zoom meetings. The great thing about Zoom is it allows you to conference in other hosts, so you can have multiple people presenting during your live streams. Pair it with the BoxCast platform, and you can stream to an unlimited number of viewers and social destinations. Today we're going to show you how to take your Zoom meetings and stream them to multiple platforms at once using BoxCast. This includes Facebook Live, YouTube Live, and just about anywhere else you'd want to stream to. We like to call this Zoomcasting. So let's dive right in, and if you stick around at the end, we'll give you some bonus tips on making your Zoom videos look better. Okay, so the first thing you'll want to do is open up your Zoom account on a web browser and enable it for live streaming. Go to the Settings tab, click here, and scroll down to Allow Live Streaming Meetings. Once you click this, you'll see the option to push your stream to these other destinations. Click Custom Live Streaming Service, which will lead us to our next step, setting up a Zoom in the BoxCast dashboard. Basically, we need to give an address to Zoom so they know where to send the stream when you go live. Head over to your BoxCast dashboard. In the dashboard, click on Sources and add a source. You're going to click RTMP Source from here. Let's name it Zoom, so when we go to schedule a BoxCast broadcast, we can easily identify it as our Zoom account. Now click on your new Zoom source, and you'll see your address info right here. We'll want to copy and paste this info into the live stream settings on your Zoom account, so you can easily reference it each time you go live with a meeting. Okay, pause. I know this seems like a lot of steps so far, but now that you have this part set up, you're not gonna have to do it again. So on to step three, scheduling the Zoomcast. In your Zoom account, click Schedule a Meeting. Fill out this basic information and make sure you schedule your Zoom meeting a few minutes before you actually wanna go live to the public. This way, you have a little buffer room to get set up once you enter the meeting. Now just click Save, and your Zoom meeting is scheduled. Head over to your BoxCast dashboard and do the same exact thing. Schedule a broadcast, fill out the info, and then make sure to select Zoom as a source so that BoxCast knows where the stream is coming from. From here, you can select all the social destinations you want to push your stream to as well. And click Schedule. A few minutes before your stream goes live, hop into Zoom and set up your screen the way you want it to look while you're streaming. Then click here and select Custom Live Streaming Service. You'll be directed to this page, and look at that! Here's that address information we saved in our Zoom settings earlier. Paste in the URL and stream key here, and paste a link to the publicly facing live stream here, whether that be your BoxCast TV link or a simulcast link. Click Go Live, and you'll start to see your Zoomcast prepare. Once you're live, you'll see your status in your Zoom meeting, and you can monitor the stream in your BoxCast dashboard. Here you can also verify that your social destinations are working. So that's how it works. And now that you've got your Zoomcast set up, it's time for the bonus section. So here's three quick tips on making your Zoom videos look better. Number one, add some simple lighting. Pointing a lamp or another light source towards your face will look so much better than the natural lighting in your room. Avoid having a window or another major light source behind you so you don't look dark and scary. Number two, keep your camera at eye level. This is a much better angle and will give you a better chance at connecting with your audience, whether you're using a laptop camera or an external camera. If you don't have an external camera, put your laptop on a box or a set of books to make it look more level. And number three, address the camera. Now it might sound silly, but when you're web conferencing with another person, you naturally tend to look at their video feed on the screen instead of the laptop's camera. When you're live streaming these meetings to outside viewers, it may feel like you're not maintaining eye contact. Don't forget to occasionally look at the camera when you're addressing your audience. It's a subtle difference that will go a very long way. So that's all we have for today. You can check out all the gear we recommend for Zoomcasting in the description below. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up, like, and subscribe. And if you have any other questions about Zoomcasting or anything else live streaming related, let us know in the comments. Thanks for watching and happy streaming.